Welcome back. Summer is finally here and plenty of sunshine for Sydney on the first day of December. We even had a little storm to kick off the season. Here you can see the dark clouds and showers falling to the southwest of the city. Camden getting the biggest downpour, recording 6.2 millimetres. Temperatures today slightly above average. Richmond, Penrith and Campbelltown reaching the low 30s. The city stopping at 27 with mostly light winds. The heaviest showers today over southeastern New South Wales. Tops generally in the high 20s across inland parts. Warm on the north coast, hitting 35 in Grafton, but a cooler day on the south coast thanks to those southerlies. Batemans Bay stopping at 22. More rain on the way tomorrow, troughs triggering showers and storms along the coast, with most of the action in that southeast corner, up to 4 millimetres for Canberra with a top of 25. A cooler day in Melbourne and Hobart, not even making the 20s. Back home to New South Wales, and here's a closer look at those scattered showers in the southeast. There's also the chance of isolated thunderstorms, which could be severe. Isolated showers and possible storms for the remainder of the east, and mostly dry and partly cloudy for the western half. Daytime temperatures below average across the south, but mostly near average in the north. A bit of a mixed bag for Sydney tomorrow. Partly cloudy skies, so thankfully some sunshine to start our weekend, but there is a high chance of showers, most likely in the afternoon and evening. Plus, there's also the chance of a storm. The Bureau is expecting 1 to 15 millimetres in our west and 0 to 7 across the east. Temperatures much like today though, high 20s again in our west, up to 29 degrees in Richmond and Penrith. The city heading for a top of 26, and overnight temperatures around 16 to 19, so slightly warmer than average. Not as wet on Sunday though, with just a shower or two and less than a millimetre forecast, a top of 27 for the city. A few degrees cooler on Monday with just a possible shower, then high 20s and loads of sunshine for the rest of the week. Our west also expecting a shower or two on Sunday, warming up to 30. The fine weather returns turning on Monday, and then temperatures staying in the 30s, up to 35 on Wednesday and 39 next Friday. Summer starting with a bang, Jane.
Hello again, and Melbourne was under mostly cloudy skies for the first day of summer. The city dipped to 14 degrees and peaked at 24 this afternoon. Widespread showers continued over central and eastern districts overnight, and in the 24 hours to 9 a.m. there were some significant totals through Gippsland. Balook recorded 167 millimetres and 108 at Combined Bar. It's generally been a dry day across Melbourne, and it's been warmer. Most suburbs climbed into the low to mid 20s. It warmed up in the high 20s through the state's north, a bit cooler in the south, and there's been light to moderate rain in the east, but most locations have recorded less than 20 millimetres so far. Tomorrow, an upper level system will deliver more wet weather to eastern and central districts, and showers will continue on Sunday before contracting to the east and easing throughout the day. Then we've got a dry day on Monday, and daytime temperatures are set to rise. Taking a look around the country for tomorrow, it'll be a showery start to the weekend for eastern capitals. Canberra can expect up to 4 millimetres, up to 7 in Sydney, a light shower or two in Hobart, and a top of 19 degrees. Back home, it'll be another mostly cloudy day in the south with maximums in the high teens, and under mostly sunny skies in the northwest, it's heading for the mid-20s. There'll be scattered showers over central and eastern districts with areas of rain. Orbost is forecast to get 40 millimetres, 25 to 35 millimetres for other locations throughout Gippsland, and less than 15 elsewhere. There's also the chance of isolated thunderstorms in the east. And the Avon and Thompson rivers are under major flood warnings, while the Snowy, McAllister and Mitchell rivers are under a moderate warning. Showers will return across Melbourne overnight, and they'll stick with us for most of the day tomorrow. The highest totals are expected in the eastern suburbs, up to 20 millimetres and up to 15 elsewhere. Temperature-wise, there'll be minimums of 14 or 15 degrees, and it won't get much warmer, with maximums of 17 or 18 under cloudy skies. Geelong is heading for 17 with up to 9 millimetres of showers from the morning and afternoon. The city can expect up to 15 millimetres and a cloudy top of 17 degrees. It will be better on Sunday, 22 degrees under partly cloudy skies and the chance of a light shower or two in the morning. And then the temperature takes a jump, 31 degrees on Monday with breaks of sunshine, 28 degrees on Tuesday after a warm low of 20, a top of 22 on Wednesday, 25 on Thursday, and the showers return next Friday up to 8 millimetres and 28 degrees. A cool and wet day tomorrow. After a low of 16, the city is set to reach 17 degrees with up to 15 millimetres of showers throughout the day.
Absolutely, Melissa. Not hard to work out where these storms this evening have come from. Those scorching temps helped triggering these storms. The severe thunderstorm warning for us in the southeast has now been cancelled. Should clear off the coast next half hour or so. Still a severe thunderstorm warning in place, though, for parts of Wide Bay stretching up to the Capricornia coast. Could see a repeat performance for us in the southeast tomorrow. Have a look at those temperatures today. It was an absolute scorcher for the first day of summer. 35 degrees in the city. It was actually our fourth warmest day of the year. 35 the top for Ipswich as well. 34 for the top for the Sunshine Coast. A little bit cooler here on the Gold Coast. Tomorrow's weather map, you can see that trough through our central interior for Queensland. That's moving east as it moves off the coast tomorrow. We're a chance of seeing more storms triggered. If you're heading into state tomorrow, showers on the way for Sydney, Melbourne, Hobart and also Adelaide. And I could see a possible storm in the top end for Darwin. Back home, showers for Cairns and areas further north. Partly cloudy, though, for Townsville and Mackay. And then storms are possible through the interior for the Isa right the way through to Roma. Through the Capricornia Coast tomorrow, partly cloudy day for both Rocky and Gladstone. It's from the Fraser Coast we could see that storm activity fire up again, particularly around Gympie and into the Sunshine Coast. In our backyard, high chance of showers for all of us, only looking at a couple of millimetres. But then we could see those storms again in the afternoon, and the temps a little bit cooler than what we saw today, reaching the low 30s along the coast and just the mid 30s in the west. For Moreton Bay tomorrow, it'll be a beautiful morning. Northeasterly winds getting up to 20 knots by the afternoon though, and seas getting to around a metre, reaching around a metre and a half offshore. And for the city, high chance of showers, heading for a top of 33 degrees tomorrow and dipping down to 21. And then looking ahead, a great looking Sunday on the way. Could see a light shower or two for Monday, but a warm week ahead. And same goes for Ipswich, partly cloudy, 35 again on Sunday, a possible shower for Monday. For the Gold Coast, partly cloudy for our Sunday, a possible shower for Monday, a beautiful looking Tuesday and Wednesday on the way. And for the sunny coast, could see a possible storm late on Sunday, a shower or two for Monday, and mostly sunny for Tuesday.
Fantastic conditions for it, mostly clear skies, and it's currently sitting on around 20 degrees in the city. Our top today was at 25. There was a bit of cloud around Adelaide at times today, but a few sunny patches too. Temperatures have varied across the suburbs. Mawson Lakes topped at 27, Glenelg 23, a little cooler up on Mount Lofty. Now there are still some roads closed in the outback due to the recent rain, but conditions are easing up there. Just a few showers around Arkuna Bluff this afternoon. And it's been a mostly dry day across the south. On the cool side along the coast, Hindmarsh Island topped at 20. Now, on the charts, you can see conditions are relatively settled across SA at the moment, but we're still seeing some wet weather over in the eastern states. Storms have been firing through Queensland this afternoon, and there's a chance of showers in Brisbane, Sydney, Canberra, Hobart and Melbourne tomorrow. Here in SA, though, mostly blue skies across our north and west. Port Augusta, a top of 25. Port Lincoln at 21. There's a chance of isolated showers around the southern agricultural area, more likely around the coasts and ranges, but not looking like anything significant. Murray Bridge and Nuriatpa 22 degrees. Victor Harbour a little fresher with 19. On local waters, southerly winds up to 25 knots and seas increasing to 1.5 metres. Across Adelaide, a mixture of sunshine and cloud, cool winds just keeping a lid on temperatures. There is a chance of a shower around the hills and southern suburbs, but mostly it should be a dry day. Top of 22 for Noarlunga, Glenelg and Golden Grove, 20 at Mount Barker. In the city, down to 13 tonight, tomorrow partly cloudy and 23. Warming up on Sunday, sunny and 27. Then we start to see some of that summer heat. So Monday 34, we have 5 days in the 30s. 35 degrees on Thursday.